Welcome to Sattu Career 2.0 Online Nursing Channel. Every Sunday, our channel is organizing an online test series for all the NIMS Nursing Officer exam aspirants. So, in the first Sunday of this month, we have organized the online test series. So, that test series answer key we are going to see in this video. It is having 100 questions. So, watch the video fully so that you can learn 100 questions in a short video. So before seeing that, please subscribe to our channel if you are not yet subscribed, and click the bell icon to get the latest notification about all the new videos. Now let's see the answer of all the 100 questions. Now let's see the first question. Adolescent has a temper tantrum. When this mother say he can't go outside, which defense mechanism is used by the children? Option A, intellectualization. Option B, denial. C, rationalization. D, regression. The right answer, the child uses regression as the defense mechanism. Regression is the defense mechanism used by the child. The question number two, pancreatitis, pituitary tumor, and pheochromocytoma may be associated with. Option A, medullary carcinoma of thyroid. Option B, papillary carcinoma of thyroid. C, anaplastic carcinoma of thyroid. Option D, follicular carcinoma of thyroid. The right answer is option A, medullary carcinoma of thyroid. Question number three, heme is converted to bilirubin mainly in. Option A, spleen. B, liver. C, kidney. D, bone marrow. The right answer is option A, spleen. Question number four, all of the following methods are anti-larval measures except. Option A, gambusia affins. Option B, Paris green. C, intermittent irrigation. D, malathion. The right answer is option D, malathion is not an anti-larval measure. Question number five, which among the following is the long-term effect of steroid therapy? Option A, steroid psychosis. B, hypoglycemia. C, loss of weight. D, alopecia. The right answer is option A, steroid psychosis is the long-term effect of steroid therapy. Question number six, image-based questions. Name the procedure which you see in this picture. Option A, radiogram. B, central venous catheter. Option D, hemodialysis catheter. Option D, angiography. The right answer is option C, it is the catheter used for hemodialysis procedure. Question number seven, which of the following statement is true about Favipriravir tablet? Regarding which statement is true? Option A, Favipriravir is an antiviral COVID-19 drug. Option B, it is India's first COVID-19 drug launched at the price rate of ₹103 per tablet. Option C, Glenmark Pharmaceuticals under the brand name Fabiflu has launched an antiviral drug called Favipriravir. The right answer is option D, all of the above is the right correct statement regarding the drug Favipriravir. Question number 8, all of the following can cause osteoporosis except. Option A, phenobarbitone. B, thyrotoxicosis. C, hyperparathyroidism. D, fluorosis. The right answer is option D, fluorosis does not cause osteoporosis. Question number 9. The type of knot used in surgery shown in the photograph is option A, granny knot. B, surgeon's knot. C, reef knot. D, hop hitch knot. So this type of knot is called option B, surgeon's knot. Now question number 10. Identify the instrument given in the image. Option A, pigtail drainage, B nasogastric tube, C tracheostomy, and D is P tube. The right answer is option A, pigtail drainage. Option A is right. Now question number 11. Pus collection shown in the photograph is typical of option A, cold abscess, B, ruptured liver abscess, option C, amoebic liver abscess, option D, fungal infection. So this image shows the ruptured liver abscess. Option B is correct. Question number 12. Water seal drainage bottle should be option A, above the chest level, B, below the chest level, C, at the chest level, D, at the head end of the bed at any level. The right answer is option C, at the level of chest. Question number 13. Which is the right place of figure of 8 bandage? Option A, scrotum support, B, elbow and knee, C, shoulder, D, mandible. The right answer for figure of 8 bandage is used for elbow and knee. Question number 14. Name the instrument which you've seen in this image. Option A, mucus extractor, B, nasal aspirator, C, chest drainage tube, and D is retention catheter. The right answer, it is mucus extractor. Question number 15. 1000 ml of normal saline is to be infused in 8 hours. What should be the rate of flow per minute? Option A, 15 drops, B, 40 drops, C, 30 drops, D, 20 drops. The right answer is option C, 30 drops. Question number 16. Ringer lactate intravenous infusion solution does not contain which of this following? Option A, sodium, B, bicarbonate, C, chloride, D, potassium. The Ringer lactate solution does not contain option B, bicarbonate. Question number 17. Which of the following ECG finding indicates the presence of hypokalemia? Option A, that is prolonged PR interval, B, tall peak T wave, option C, widening QR complex, D, ST segment depression. So this ST segment depression is the right answer, which is causing hypokalemia. Question number 18. What is the use of this treatment procedure? Option A, rush catheter, B, low pressure tamponade, C, pericardial tamponade, D, Bakri balloon tamponade. So the right procedure name which you've seen in this image is option D, Bakri balloon tamponade. Question number 19. The recommended daily energy intake for an adult woman with heavy work is option A, 2300 kilocalories, B, 1800 kilocalories, C, 2900 kilocalories, option D, 2100 kilocalories. For an adult woman who is doing heavy work, she needs option C, 2900 kilocalories daily. Question number 20. All of the following are topically used sulfonamides except option A, sulfadiazine, B, sulfacetamide, option C, mefenamide, D, silver sulfadiazine. So the topically used sulfonamide is option A, sulfadiazine. Question number 21. The highest percentage of polyunsaturated fatty acids are present in option A, palm oil, B, groundnut oil, C, soya bean oil, option D, marag grain. Which is the substance having the highest percentage of polyunsaturated fatty acids? The right answer is soya bean oil. Question number 22. The natural sedative in meat and milk products, especially warm milk, that can help to induce sleep is option A, flurazepam, B, tamazepam, option C, tryptophan, option D, methotrexate. the natural substance which is inducing sleep, which is seen in the milk, is option C, tryptophan. Question number 23. Glycosylated hemoglobin, HbA1c, test measures the average blood glucose control of an individual over the previous 3 months. Which of the following value is considered as a diagnosis of pre-diabetes? Option A, 6.527%, B, 5.7 to 6.4%, option C, 5 to 5.6%, option D, more than 5.6%. So the right answer is option B, 5.7 to 6.4%. Next question. Nursing intervention that can help the patient to relax and sleep restfully includes all of the following except option A, massage the patient's back with long strokes, option B, provide quiet music and interesting reading material, option C, have your patient take 30 to 60 minute nap in the afternoon, option D, turn on the television in the patient room. So the right answer, option C, have the patient to take 30 to 60 minutes nap in the afternoon. That will help the patient to get sleep full, the rest peacefully at night. Question number 25. Which of the following symptom is the best indicator of imminent death? Option A, a weak slow pulses. Option B, increased muscle tone. Option C, fixed dilated pupils. Option D, slow shallow respiration. The right answer is, in imminent death, the best indicator is fixed dilated pupils. Question number 26. Why BCG is given only up to 1 year of age? Option A, can be given after 1 year of age also. Option B, as it is less painful. Option C, more children occur clinical and subclinical tuberculosis infection by the age of 1 year. Option D, side effect are more after 1 year of age. So the right answer is option C, more children occurs clinical and subclinical tuberculosis infection by the age of 1 year. Question number 27. Which of the following sentence is true about ORS? Option A, 1 packet of ORS should be mixed with 1 liter of water and use it till the solution finishes. Option B, 1 packet of ORS should be mixed with 1 liter of water and use it for 7 days. Option C, 1 packet of ORS should be mixed with 0.5 liters of water and use it till the solution finishes. Option D, 1 packet of ORS should be mixed with 1 liter of water and use it within 24 hours. So the right statement, true about ORS, is option D. It should be mixed with 1 liter of water and it should be used within 24 hours. Question number 28. What temperature should be stored in the ice-lined refrigerators to store vaccines? Option A, between 12%, that is plus 2 degrees Celsius to plus 8 degrees Celsius. Option B, between minus 2 degrees Celsius to minus 8 degrees Celsius. Option C, between minus 1 degree Celsius to plus 8 degrees Celsius. Option D, between minus 1 degree Celsius to plus 7 degrees Celsius. So that is the temperature need to be stored in the ice line refrigerator for vaccines. Question number 29. Option A is right, plus 2 degree to plus 8 degree Celsius. Question number 29. How many prophylactic doses of vitamin A should be given under UIP universal immunization program? Option A, 6, B, 7, C, 8, D, 9. So under universal immunization program, we need to give 9 prophylactic doses of vitamin A. Question number 20. A 2-year-old is to be admitted in the pediatric unit. He is diagnosed with febrile seizures. In preparing for his admission, which of the following is the most important nursing action? Option A, order a stat admission on complete blood count. Option B, place a urine collection bag and specimen cup at the bedside. Option C, place a cooling mattress on his bed. Option D, pad the side rails of his bed. So the right answer, option C, place a cooling mattress on his bed. Question number 31. The physician's order reads, administer 1 gram, this is cefazolin sodium, in 150 ml of normal saline solution for 60 minutes. What is the flow rate if the drop factor is 10 GTT, which is equal to 1 ml? Option A, 25 GTT per minute, B, 37 GTT per minute, C, 50 GTT per minute, option D, 60 GTT per minute. So the right answer is option A, 25 GTT per minute is the right answer. Question number 32. A patient must be receiving 50 units of Humulin, that is regular insulin. The label reads 100 units is equal to 1 ml. How many milliliters should be the nurse administer? Option A, 0.5 ml, B, 0.75 ml, C, 1 ml, D, 2 ml. So the right answer is 0.5 ml, the nurse should administer. Question number 33. The nurse is teaching a patient to prepare a syringe with 40 units of 100 NPH insulin for self-injection. The patient's first priority concerning the self-injection in the situation is to, option A, assess the injection site, B, select appropriate injection site, option C, clean the injection site in a circular manner with alcohol sponge, option D, check the syringe to verify that the nurse has removed the prescribed insulin dose. So the right answer is before giving the injection, the client need to select the appropriate injection site. Question number 34. The most common cause of UTI The most common cause of UTI in community is, it is not communication, it is community. Option A, Citrobacter, B, Proteus vulgaris, C, Klebsiella, D, E. coli. The right answer, the most common UTI in community is E. coli. It is not communication, it is community. Question number 35. The most common cause of UTI. Now we go to the next question. What is the action of Tramadol? Option A, antifungal, B, antiviral, C, analgesic, and D, antidepressant. Tramadol is an analgesic agent. Question number 37. Identify the type of this traction. Option A, balanced traction, B, Hamilton-Russell traction, C, Buck's traction, D, Gallows traction. So this traction is option D, Gallows traction. Question number 38. The type of surgical suture shown in the photograph is, option A, subcuticular suture, option B, horizontal mattress, option C, simple interrupter, option D, vertical mattress. So this type of suture is option A, subcuticular sutures. Question number 39. What is the term used for high-pitched musical sounds in clients during respiratory assessment? Option A, crooning, B, wheezing, C, stridor, D, sigh. The high-pitched musical sound in respiratory assessment indicates wheezing. Option B, wheezing is right answer. Question number 40. A woman in labor is receiving antibiotic. C, suddenly complains of trouble in breathing, weakness and nausea. The nurse should recognize that these signs are usually the indicative of impending. Option A, bronchospasm, B, anaphylaxis, C, amniotic fluid embolism. Option D, pulmonary egophony. So these symptoms are indication of option B, anaphylaxis. Question number 41. When caring for a client with a femoral venous catheter, it is essential for the nurse to option A, irrigate the catheter with sterile saline solution to maintain patency. Option B, limit the mobility of the affected limb. Option C, maintain sterile technique when working with the catheter. Option D, assess the pressure dressing frequently for bleeding. The right answer is option A, irrigate the catheter with sterile saline solution to maintain the patency. Question number 42. Which of the following nursing intervention should be most important for determining the fluid balance in a client with end-stage renal failure? Option A, monitor urine-specific gravity. Option B, record frequency of bowel movements. Option C, measures fluid intake and output. Option D, check weights daily. So the right answer, option B, checking the weight daily, is the exact answer for this question. Question number 43. The goal of nursing is to put the patient in the best condition for nature to act upon him. This was stated by option A, Jean Watson, B, Virginia Henderson, C, Florence Nightingale, D, Martha Rogers. The right answer is option C, Florence Nightingale suggested. For treatment, we need to give the best nature. Option C, Florence Nightingale is right answer. Question number 44. Physical signs indicative of poor nutrition are all except option A, dental caries, mottled appearance, that is fluorosis, and malposition. Option B is brittle, depigmented, easily plugged, thin and sparse hair. Option C, tongue, deep red in appearance, surface papillae present. Option D, spongy bleed easily, marginal redness, and recession gums. So the right answer, option C, tongue red in appearance, surface papillae present. That is the good sign of nutrition. That is not poor sign of nutrition here. Question number 45. Which route of drug administration is used in the photograph? Option A, dermojet. B, pellet implant. C, intradermal. D, subcutaneous. The right answer is option A, dermojet. Question number 46. The drug shown below is given to infants 5 weeks older to treat which condition? Option A, neonatal jaundice. Option B, ophthalmic neonatum. C, infantile hemangioma. D, cradle cap. So this medicine is used to treat infantile hemangioma. Option C is right here. Question number 47. As the body continues to try to compensate for hypovolemic shock, there is increased angiotensin 2 from the activation of the renin angiotensin aldosterone system. What physiological change occurs related to the increased angiotensin 2? Option A, vasodilatation. B, decreased blood pressure, which is accompanied with carbon monoxide. Option B, aldosterone release results in sodium and water excretion. Option D, antidiuretic hormone release, which is increasing the water reabsorption. So the mechanism which is related to increase angiotensin 2 is option D, antidiuretic hormone release increases the water reabsorption. Question number 48. Drug of choice for deep vein thrombosis prophylaxis surgical patient is option A, intravenous infractionated heparin. Option B, subcutaneous unfractionated heparin. Option C, gamma globulin. Option D, warfarin. The right answer is the deep vein thrombosis prophylaxis, the drug of choice is subcutaneous unfractionated heparin. Question number 49. The drug shown in the picture below is contraindicated in which among the following cases? Option A, antispasmodic. Option B, antibiotic. Option C, antifungal. Option D, anticancer. So this drug, the action, this is the action of the action is antispasmodic. Question number 50, the catheter is option A, which is shown in the images. Option A, cord catheters. Option B, Nailaton catheter. Option C, Primacat. Option D, Swan neck catheter. So this catheter is option B, Nailaton catheter. So now let's see the second 50 questions in this question paper. So 51, popcorn calcification in the breast is the classical description for the classification seen involving calcification seen involuting option A, tubular adenoma. Option B, villous adenoma. Option C, fibroadenoma. Option D, sessile serrated adenoma. So this calcification, the right answer is, it is a popcorn calcification that is related to fibroadenoma. Option C, fibroadenoma is right answer. Question number 52, the antineoplastic agent that act by altering the DNA structure are option A, mitotic spindle position. Option B, hormonal agents. Option C, anti-metabolites. Option D, alkylating agents. So the right answer is option D, alkylating agents. Question number 53, in brain death, all are seen except option A, apnea. B, constricted pupils. Option C, diabetes insipidus. Option D, pulse rate unresponsive to atrophy. So in brain death, all can be seen except constricted pupils. Question number 54, the nurse is performing an assessment on a patient who is taking propranolol for supraventricular tachycardia. Which assessment finding is an indication that patient is experiencing an adverse effect of this drug? Option A, paresthesia. B, bradycardia. C, dry mouth. D, urinary retention. The right answer is option D, bradycardia. Now let's see the next question. 55, who developed the hierarchy of needs? Option A, Piaget. Option B, Maslow. Option C, Erikson. Option D, Nightingale. So the hierarchy of needs was developed by Abraham Maslow. Option B is right. Question number 56, satiety center is situated in which part of the brain? Option A, cerebrum. B, cerebellum. C, thalamus. D, hypothalamus. The satiety center is situated in the option D, hypothalamus. Question number 57, a nurse is providing health teachings regarding antiplatelet medication. Which of the following is not true regarding the use of this medication? Option A, antiplatelet medications inhibits the aggregation of platelets in the clotting process, thereby prolonging bleeding time. Option B, antiplatelet medications cannot be used with anticoagulants. Option C, take the medications with the food to prevent gastrointestinal upset. Option D, a routine bleeding time is monitored during the therapy. The right answer is we need to take this drug we cannot take with the anticoagulant agents. Question number 58, the position seen in the image, option A, Nietzsche's position. B, jackknife position. C, Trendelenburg position. D, low lithotomic position. The right answer is option B, jackknife position. Question number 59, a client is receiving procainamide for the treatment of ventricular arrhythmia. The client suddenly complains of nausea and drowsiness. Which of the interventions should the nurse do first? Option A, check the blood pressure and heart rate. Option B, measure the heart rate and the rhythm strip. Option C, give hydralazine, that is hydrolysis per order. Option D is do a 12-lead ECG right away. So the right answer is option A, check the blood pressure and heart rate. Question number 60, the surgical instrument option A, tenotomy scissor, B, iris scissor, C, curved Mayo scissor, option D, Meissenbaum scissor. The right answer is Meissenbaum scissor is the right answer. Question number 61, according to Simon classification of gynecomastia, stage 2B is described as option A, slight volume increase with no excess skin. Option B, moderate volume increase with no excess skin. Option C, moderate volume increase with excess skin. Option D, marked volume increase with excess skin. The Simon classification of gynecomastia stage 2B is option C, moderate volume increase with excess skin. Question number 62, how much blood can be withdrawn by an cyclostoma in 24 hours? Option A, 0.34 to 0.5 ml. Option B, 2 to 4 ml. Option C, 0.1 to 0.8 ml. Option D, 0.15 to 0.26 ml. So the right answer is option D, 0.15 to 0.26 ml of blood can be withdrawn through an ancyclostoma in 24 hours. Question number 63, hypercapnia indicates the situation of option A, high partial pressure of carbon dioxide, option B, high partial pressure of carbon monoxide, option C, high partial pressure of carbon disulfide, option D, high partial pressure of superoxygen. So the hypercapnia indicates high partial pressure of carbon dioxide. Question number 64, bioavailability of IV formulation is option A, 50%, B, 25%, C, 75%, D, 100%. The bioavailability of IV formulation is exactly 100%. Option D is right here. Question number 65, average diameter of RBC in a micrometer scale is option A, 6, B, 8, C, 14, option D, 20. So the average diameter of RBC in micrometer is option C, 8 micrometer. B is correct. Option B is correct. Now question number 66, in iodine poisoning, which antidote is used? A, sodium lactate, B, starch, option C, sucrose, option D, calcium chloride. So the antidote used in iodine poisoning, option B, starch, is correct. Question number 66, if menstrual cycle shorter than 21 days is known as option A, polymenorrhea, option B, metrohagia, option C, oligomenorrhea, option D, menometrohagia. So the menstrual cycle shorter than 21 days is called polymenorrhea. Option A is right. Question number 68, vitamin M is also known as A, aspartic acid, B, folic acid, C, lactic acid, D, glycolic acid. So vitamin M is known as option B, folic acid. Question number 69, a client with beta thalassemia is receiving therapy that includes multiple blood transfusion. The child is at risk for developing which complication? Option A, allergic response, B, serum hepatitis, C, hemolytic reaction, option D, pulmonary edema. So when there is multiple blood transfusion, the child is risk for pulmonary edema due to overload of blood. Question number 70, a nurse teaches a client about warfarin, Comodin. Which juice is to be avoided by the client that indicates that teaching is effective? Option A, apple juice, B, grape juice, C, orange juice, D, cranberry juice. The right answer, option D, cranberry juice, need to be avoided when the client is in the warfarin therapy. Question number 71, during the postpartum period, a nurse identifies that the client's rubella titer is negative. What action should the nurse plan to take? Option A, obtain a prescription for an immunization before discharge. Option B, assure that the client has active immunity. Option C, alert the staff in the newborn nursery. Option D, check the allergies to penicillin. So when the rubella titer is negative, the nurse should tell the client that she is having active immunity towards rubella. Question number 72. A healthcare provider prescribes Iosartan for client, which is the most important nursing action? Option A, assess the client for hypokalemia. B, monitor the client blood pressure during therapy. Option C, ensure that the medication is ingested with the food. Option D, teach that missile dose can be doubled at the next scheduled time. So when the client is in Iosartan, the nurse's responsibility is to monitor the blood pressure throughout the therapy. Option B is right. Question number 73. A nurse is caring for a child with a very low platelet count related to chemotherapy. The nurse should monitor the child's urine for the presence of which constituent? Option A, protein. B, glucose. C, erythrocyte. D, lymphocyte. The right answer, erythrocyte count should be monitored. Option C is right. Now, question number 74. A client is receiving vincristine. What should the nurse expect in the dietary plan to include to minimize the side effect of vincristine? Option A, low in fat. B, high in iron. C, high in fluids. D, low residue diet. So the right answer is high fluid diet should be recommended to those who are in vincristine therapy. Question number 75. What is the important nursing care for children with leukemia on chemotherapeutic protocols? Option A, preventing physical activity. B, checking their vital signs every 2 hours. Option C, having them avoid contact with the infected persons. Option D, reducing the unnecessary stimuli in their environment. So the right answer is option C, having them to avoid contact with the infected person is the right answer here. Question number 76. The nurse is assessing a client with major depression. Which clinical manifestation reflects disturbance in affect related to depression? Option A, delusion. B, echolalia. C, hopelessness. D, confusion. So the symptom related to depression, option C, hopelessness. Question number 77. What concept of death should a nurse expect a preschool age child to have? Option A, cessation of life. B, reversible separation. Option C, happening that affects older people. Option D, someone who takes one away from the family. So in the preschool age children concept related to death, the right answer is option B, reversible separation. Question number 78. Which clinical findings should the nurse expect when assessing a client with hyperthyroidism? Select all that apply. Option A, exophthalmos. B, lethargy. C, weight. This is weight loss. Option D, constipation. So in hyperthyroidism, this is exophthalmos is present. Question number 79. What is the procedure seen in the image? Option A, NG tube feeding. Option B, gastrostomy tube. Option C, combi tube. Option D, endotracheal intubation. So this is gastrostomy tube. Option B is right. Next question. Question number 80. Name the object shown below. Option A, endotracheal tube. B, oropharyngeal tube. Option C, tracheostomy tube. Option D, combi tube. So it is a tracheostomy tube. Question number 81. Identify the following instrument seen in the image. Option A, Heger dilator. B, vaginal speculum. Option C, nasal speculum. Option D, anoscope with obturator. The right answer is anoscope with obturator. Next question. Which risk factor places the patients and the residents at the greatest risk for falls? Option A, old age. B, middle teens. Option C, COPD decline. Option D, pneumonia. So the risk factor for falls include the old age patients. Question number 83. which patient should be evacuated first to first in the event of a fire within the area? Option A, immediate immobile patients or patients on life support. Option B, small children and ambulatory patients. Option C, patients requiring transfer assistance or use of a stretcher. Option D, patients in wheelchairs or who can ambulate with the walkers. The right answer is, we need to shift the small children and ambulatory patients first. Question number 84. A patient is confused to their bed and need assistance at meal. What position should you place the bed when you're feeding the patient? The right answer, option A, high Fowler's, B, supine, C, reversed Cranenberg, D, lateral. So the right answer is option A, high Fowler's position. Question number 84. Asepsis is defined as option A, absence of disease causing germs. Option B, absence of all microorganisms. Option C, urinary infection. Option D, pathogenic infection. The right answer is asepsis is defined as the options of disease causing germs. Question number 86. A nurse is caring for a client receiving a heparin intravenously. The nurse expects that which of the following laboratory report will be prescribed to monitor the therapeutic effect of heparin? Option A, prothrombin time. B, activated prothromboplastin time. Option C, hematocrit. Option D, hemoglobin. So the right answer is option B, activated prothrombin thromboplastin time. Question number 87. Which of the following hospital floors would you most likely expect to see reverse isolation precautions? Option A, surgical. B, oncological. C, Alzheimer's. D, obstetrics. The right answer for reverse isolation precaution we need to do in the oncological floors. Question number 88. You notice a patient is walking with a shuffling gait with a walker and has jerky movements of the arms and legs. The patient has some difficulty in speaking, but the patient is alert and oriented. What do you suspect in this related to the symptoms of the patient? Option A, coronary artery disease. B, COPD. C, urinary tract infection. Option D, Parkinson's disease. The right answer is option D, Parkinson's disease. Question number 89. A client is receiving intravenous heparin therapy. The nurse ensures the availability in which of the following medication? Option A, calcium gluconate. B, vitamin K. C, acetylcysteine. Option D, protamine sulfate. So in this case, the medication option D, protamine sulfate, is the right answer. So nurse should ensure the availability of protamine sulfate. Question number 90. A client with deep vein thrombosis receiving streptokinase. The nurse would notify the physician if which of the following assessment is noted. Option A, respiratory rate 25 breaths per minute, blood pressure of 185 by 100, 10 millimeter of mercury. Option C, pulse rate of 99 beats per minute, temperature rate of 99.2 degree Fahrenheit. The right answer, the blood pressure of 185 and 110 millimeter of mercury should be reported to the physician. Question number 91, which is considered a normal and healthy type of grief? Option A, anticipatory grief. B, complicated grief. C, inhibited grief. D, unresolved grief. The right answer is option A, anticipatory grief. Question number 92. A client with myocardial infarction is receiving tissue plasminogen activator, ATPase, which while on the therapy, the nurse plans to prioritize which of the following? Option A, observe for neurological signs. Option B, monitor for any signs of renal failure. Option D, check the food diary. Option D, observe for signs of bleeding. So the right answer is option D, observe for signs of bleeding is right. Question number 93. You are caring for patient Thomas. Thomas is 77 year old. He has edema or swelling in his legs, and he has a fluid restriction in terms of his fluid intake. You have been assigned to weigh him daily. Based on these symptoms and the care that he is being given, what disorder is to be most likely affected with? Option A, diabetes. B, dementia. C, congestive heart failure. D, contagious heart failure. The right answer is option C, congestive heart failure. Question number 94. Broca's motor speech area is situated in which lobe of brain? Option A, temporal lobe. B, occipital lobe. C, frontal lobe. And D, parietal lobe. The Broca's motor area is located in the frontal area of the brain. Question number 95. The vaccine for Japanese encephalitis is option A, live mutant vaccine. B, live recombinant vaccination. C, killed vaccines. D, live attenuated vaccine. So Japanese encephalitis is a type of killed vaccine. Question number 96. Name the vaccine that is jointly developed by the German company BioNTech and US pharma giant Pfizer for COVID-19. Option A, BNT162. Option C, PicoVac. Option C, both A and B. Option D, neither A nor B. The right answer is BNT162 is the vaccine developed by a German company and the US pharma company. Question number 97. Name a clinical trial in which blood is transfused from reverse COVID-19 patient to a coronavirus patient who is in critical condition. Option A, remdesivir. B, plasma therapy. Option C, solidarity. Option D, hydroxychloroquine. The therapy name is option B, plasma therapy is right answer. Question number 98. From where coronavirus get its name? Option A, due to their surface structure of bricks. Option B, due to their leaf-like projections. Option C, due to their crow-like projections. Option D, all of the above. The right answer is due to crown-like projections. Now, the 99th question. Intrinsic factor is secreted by A, delta cell, B, chief cells, C, parietal cells, and D, enterochromaffin-like cells. The right answer, intrinsic factors are produced by option C, parietal cells. The 100th question. A patient with shortness of breath is being tested for lung cancer. Which of the following is the diagnostic test will be most conclusive? Option A, biopsy. B, chest x-ray. C, MRI scan. Option D, sputum culture. So the right answer is option A, biopsy. So these are the 100 questions which we have given in the question paper yesterday, and the first mark is secured by Tanush Sharma, and she got 184 out of 200 in this test series. Out of 200 people given the test, Tanush Sharma got 184 out of 200. So like this, we are keeping the test series regularly every Sunday. Sometimes we keep the test in between the weeks also. If you need to join the test series, it is free of cost. You can give request to join the test series in this WhatsApp number. And thanks for watching this video. And please like and comment about this video. And subscribe to our channel, Satu Career 2.0 Online Nursing Channel. Again, we will see with another very important questions for the upcoming Nursing Officer Exam Aims 2020, September 1. Still there. Take care. Bye-bye. Stay safe. Stay alert.